And I hear him saying, well done.
That's what I heard Goliath talking. He said, wait a minute, hold on, wait a minute. Who is this uncircumcised? You ever know when you get bold, when you get bold, and when you know your skills, you can see a situation and step in, and you know your, nobody else knows your skills, but when you know your skills, and there's an argument going on, and you can step in and say, I think you need to back up a little bit. Yeah, I think you need to back up a little bit. Well, who is you? You don't know me. You ever had to have that conversation with somebody? Listen, you don't know how far I will go. You don't know me. I think you need to back up and sit down and think about what you're about to do. Because you don't know what I can do. David is coming. They don't know David. And Goliath doesn't know David. And David over here, see, David got a background. David has been through some stuff. And so David hears Goliath and says, who? Who is this uncircumcised? Notice, nobody in the army is talking as boldly as David. And David's not even in the army. But for such a time as this, where Israel is in that moment where their history can change when one battle. Here is it that one man comes and overhears the conversation of Goliath and says, that's just my game. Yeah, that y'all don't like playing like that? I like playing stuff like that. Yeah. So I like playing knuckleball. Yeah, I like street fights. Yeah, I don't do street fights. This is not your game, but it's just my game. That's what I'm looking for right now. You're playing too much. And he says, I know your pride and the naughtiness of your. He said, David, I know you, and you got a naughty little heart. You like to get in the kind of stuff. See, y'all gotta learn something about David. David didn't steer away from fights. You know, when a fight break out, you ever notice some people, everybody take off running? When the gunshots start popping off, you remember when I was at the movie theater and the gunshots start popping off and everybody take off running? There's a few people who walk toward it and they want to go find out what's going on. There's a few people who say, yeah, that's exactly. He said, David, I know you. Why you talking and you pumping yourself up? Why don't you go back home and deal with this? I know the naughtiness that's in your heart. He says, I know your pride. We're in verse 28. I know your pride, naughtiness of thine heart. For you are come down that you might just see the battle. He said, listen, I don't even think, David, you're going to even do anything. You just instigate in verse 29. And David said, what have I now done? He said, wait a minute, calm down. Did you hear what he's been saying? He said, is there no cause? Did y'all see that in verse 29? Is there no cause? If y'all don't mind, we're going to do a little reading today. Is that all right? Some of y'all ain't read all week long. We're going to do a little reading today. He says, is there no cause? This is how I read the Bible in my private time. I just get excited all by myself. Is there no cause? Ain't nobody else on. Is there no cause? And the Bible says, and he turned from him toward another and spake after the same man. He didn't stop talking.
Amen.
His older brother said, hey man, be quiet. David said, man, is there no cause? And then he started going to the other side. He said, hey, listen, y'all. Is there no cause? Man up, let's go. He said, David, why you? Hey, listen, we just trying to wait this out. Maybe Goliath will catch a cold or something. And maybe, you know, something. We waiting for something to happen. Maybe God will do something. He said, nah, that's the moment right now.
But do you know how Saul heard what David said? It's because David kept walking up and down the army and kept talking. He kept talking. And the Bible says he would turn to another. He kept talking. He said, something need to be done. We need to whip him. We need to get him right now. Come on, y'all. And he kept talking. And somebody was watching David and said, I'm going to go tell the king. The Bible says he went and told Saul. And he says, hey, Saul, there's this dude out here.
Right.
And he's saying that he can do it. The Bible says in verse 32, and David, in the verse 31, Saul had sent for him. In verse 32, and David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with this Philistine. David walked in the presence of the king. He said, oh, y'all, calm down. It's all good. I got this. This is what I do. This, matter of fact, this this just my lane. This just my field. This is what I do. I fight for a living. I fight for a living. He says, I got this Philistine. You're a little boy. He says, that man, that's a full grown man. Goliath wasn't just a warrior. The Bible says he was a champion. Do you know what you have to do to become a champion? You got to win out. Yeah, you got to win out. You got to be the last one standing. So the man who's talking is not somebody who has no experience. The man who's talking is one who has been tested and has been found successful. Someone who's been training all his life for this moment, he's been groomed for this moment. You're just showing up for the show. Davis, you ever had somebody talk to you and they don't know your resume? You don't know your resume. Even though you may not have been known around, you almost want to sit somebody down and say, let me tell you a little bit about me. That's what David is about to do. The Bible says in verse 34, and David said unto Saul, thy servant kept his father's sheep. And there came a lion and a what? And a bear. And I took the lamb out of the flock. And took a lamb out of the flock, and I went out after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he arose against me, I caught him by his beard, and I smote him, and I smote him. I had a lion and a bear, and they took my sheep, and I took off. Have you ever seen a man take off after a lion? And he said, I'm cold. I ran after the lion. I ran after the bear. I took the sheep out of his mouth. And when he rose up against me, I handled it. He says, I fought lions and bears. This is nothing to me. I've been in the wilderness. I know what it's like to see the enemy growl at you. Yeah, he's a big man. But I fought bears. I know how to fight bears. I know how to fight lions. And I've won. You call him a champion? I consider my own self a champion. Now here's the difficult part about this. David was the only one in the wilderness. It wasn't a crowd of people. He's giving his resume to Saul. And Saul just has to take his word for it. Listen. They tried to give him a sword and a shield. They tried to give him armor, but that's not what he does. He says, I need to be free. I need to be mobile. And I just need some rocks and I need a slingshot and I'm good. The Bible says that when he stepped out on the field and in the valley, the Bible says he took one smooth stone and he whipped it up because he knew what he was doing. When you've been somewhere before, you're not even worried about the atmosphere. He was moving it maybe just like this. He was just moving it just like this. And the Bible says, and he threw the stone. And the Bible says the stone sunk in the middle of Goliath. Goliath never even laid a hand. That's how cold. When you're that cold, when you can knock somebody like a haymaker, when you can knock somebody and they don't even touch you, the Bible says he threw this and it sunk in the middle of his head. And the Bible says that when David got close to him, then he pulled Goliath's own sword and cut off Goliath's head. Right. And then he took Goliath's head and took it to the king. So I told you.
I hear you saying, well done. Oh, Lord.